Welcome to Asking the Question. In this module, we will discuss developing a concise statement using the Pico Model. As we learned in the previous module, the first step in evidence-based practice is to ask a compelling question or provide a statement of the issue. This initial statement of the issue or asking the question will then guide the literature search and the rest of the evidence-based process. Here again is the graphic that demonstrates the EBP process. To write a question, we will use the Pico model. P stands for patient, population, or problem. You may wish to limit your population to a particular age group or other special subgroup. I represents intervention or exposure. This could be a new medication, a diagnostic test, or an educational intervention. With the intervention, you should try to be as specific as possible. C is for comparison group or intervention. This may include a placebo, it can include the current standard of care, or even be compared with a group that has no exposure to the intervention. Sometimes your question may not have a comparison group, and that is okay. O is for outcome. This is the result that you want to observe and measure. So, using the heart failure care case study, our PICO question might be, in adult patients with heart failure, does patient education improve compliance and reduce readmissions? Adult patients with heart failure is the population problem. The intervention is patient education. And the outcome is improved compliance and reduced readmissions. For this question, there is no comparison group. Again, here is our problem. 6.5 million adults in the United States have heart failure. At community hospital, the mortality rate from heart failure is 3.49%. We know that 22% of people with heart failure are under the age of 60. We know that heart failure involves 11 million physician visits each year, and a lot of hospitalizations as well. And at community hospital, the average stay is 5 days, and the readmission rate is greater than 21%. Based on this case study, what ideas do you have for interventions? Maybe you are considering teaching sessions to patients about the causes, signs, and symptoms of heart failure, or nutrition and behavior modification. You might also be thinking of educating healthcare providers on patient health literacy so that the providers will be better prepared in talking with their patients. Now let's practice identifying the different parts of the PICO question. Here are a few titles of research articles, and inside each of these titles, you can pick out the PICO question. Let's look at the first one. Tai Chi with music improves quality of life among community-dwelling older persons with mild to moderate depressive symptoms, a cluster randomized controlled trial. The population here is community-dwelling older persons with depressive symptoms. The intervention is Tai Chi with music. There is no comparison group, and the outcome is improved quality of life. In the second title, evaluation of text messaging effects on the health goal adherence in the management of participants with chronic diseases. What is the population here? If you said participants with chronic diseases, you would be correct. How about the intervention? Yes, text messaging. And again, in this instance, there's no comparison. And what is the outcome here? Did you say health goal adherence? That's correct. In the last citation, swimming training improves mental health parameters, cognition, and motor coordination in children with attention deficit hyperactivity disorder. What is our population? Did you say children with ADHD? That's correct. What is our intervention? Yes, swimming training. There's no comparison. And for outcome, if you said improved mental health parameters, cognition, and motor coordination, you are correct. Thank you for listening to this brief module on creating a PICO question.